Hey family, welcome to another encouragement here at I'm Second Channel. My name is Brother, because it doesn't matter who I am. The only one that matters, beloved, you know the answer. It's Yahusha HaMashiach, the son of our living Elohim. Hallelujah. He is the son of Adam. He is the King of Kings and Adonai of Adonais. Because Yahuwah, our Father, sent him to do a work, sent him to die, and he completed that work so that we can have eternal life. And so the veil in the temple will be torn, and those of us who were in opposition to Yahuwah could now be one because of the blood, because of the Besorah, the gospel, the good news that I call the awesome news. Hallelujah. All we need to do is turn away from our wickedness and put all our trust in him, not in religion, in him, not in a church setting with a bunch of people like a club, in him, hallelujah, trust him. Today, family, we're going to pray, and then I have something really good and cool to talk to you about, but on the other side of it, it's pretty serious. So right now, Sling 7 is right on the front end. And this is going to be pretty good. Hallelujah. Let's pray and then we'll get started. Abba Yah, thank you so much for who you are. Thank you for the people of Yahuwah, your children. Thank you for Jacob, the true Hebrew Israelites. The world doesn't know that you still have a bloodline people in the earth. And when you were talking to Abraham, who was the father of our faith, he said that you told him he would have a seed. This seed didn't turn to a spiritual seed. He is the bloodline seed who is those that came through the transatlantic, trans-Arabic slave trade. Also those who moved through a year and a half to, it says in the word, to Abyssinia. It took a year and a half. They moved down through from Northeast Africa to come all the way down to the west coast of Africa where the other tribes are, our brethren, the actual bloodline. The church does not take our place. Those people over in that land right now that wear the moils and the little tiny hat, they do not take our place. They are not the people. They are people that the Bible says they say they are Jewish, but they are not, but of the synagogue of Satan. Not my words. I'm not speaking hate. You know, those of you that know this channel, you know that we love at this channel, but we're going to see his hand, his mighty hand, and these prophecies being fulfilled, your prophecies, Father, through truth being spoken. This is why we are awake. We are Israel, the captives, the true captives, those that many of the world called slaves. They are royalty. It goes right into my message, Father. So we just pray for salvation for Jacob, for true Jacob, for the Hebrew Israelite, for those Gentiles who are born again and clinging unto Israel. The scripture says that. And also says, your word says, Yahusha, that as you have done unto the least of these, my children, my brethren, have you done it unto me. We'll be so very careful, Father. Show them favor. Show them your mercy. We'll be so very careful to give you all the praise, glory, and honor. And it is in the name of Yahusha. I'm sorry. I'm so excited, Father, with this reading. HaMashiach, that we do pray and say amen. So let it be. Hallelujah. Family, this is good stuff. I want to talk to you about how I used to watch, you know, Saturday morning cartoons, and every Saturday morning back in the 70s and 80s, one of the first cartoons that come on at 7 o'clock is Super Friends. Hallelujah. And I would be watching all these cartoons. A lot of you know, and you watched them, And but on these episodes, they had these episodes where this character came on, was written into the scene. His name was, he was called Bizarro Superman. He wasn't the real Superman, but he was just the opposite of him. But he thought that he was the real Superman. He thought that he was the real one. He thought that he was the good one. But he was just the opposite. I'm going to show you a scene from that. But here's it. This is what I want to talk to you about. Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro world kingdom. It's just the opposite of what we think it is. Oh, sling the sevens now. Hallelujah. Thumbs up now. Notifications now. Subscribe now. Hallelujah. It's finna get gooder and gooder. Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro world kingdom. Because it's not, it's the opposite of what you think it is. Hallelujah. So let's get right into it, and you're going to start seeing what I'm talking about. Watch this quick video, and then we're going to go to the scriptures. Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro kingdom. Hallelujah. Watch this.
Excuse me. I know you're a busy guy, but I am dying to get your autograph.
Fair use. Fair
okay.
use.
Okay. Who are you? What's the game? There's no point keeping up the act with me. The question is, who are you? Let me guess. This is all a distraction to keep me busy. If you say so, but I should warn you, your makeup's rubbing off. This is a trick. How are you doing this? Answer me!
Fair use.
Whoever you are, you don't look so good. Leave me alone!
Friend, I would call that an understatement.
Hallelujah. So that was Bizarro Superman. He thought that he himself, in his own mind, in his own heart, was the true Superman. But he wasn't. He was just the opposite. And as he got whooped and went back to his lair, as you've seen, Lex Luthor was like, you really got a problem. And family, if you are not, if you're living in this world according to your own righteousness and your own way of doing and being right and not going about the way, the truth, and the life, then you're only thinking that you're saved. You're only thinking you're born again. You only think that you have eternal life, and you do not. See, Yahusha's kingdom, his world, is a bizarro world, a bizarro kingdom. It's just the opposite of what we think it is. Let me explain to you. Let's get into it by going to the first scripture, which is in Matthew chapter 20, and beginning in verse 8, the Bible says, so when even was come, Yahusha, who is the Adonai of the vineyard, saith unto his steward, call the laborers and give them their hire, beginning from the last unto the first. And when they came that were hired about the 11th hour, they received every man a penny. But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more. And they likewise received every man a penny. They thought that they should receive the same thing. They were there first. And when they had received it, they murmured against the good men of the house. That's Yahusha. Some of us just murmur. We complain. That's all we do. Saying, these last have wrought but 1 hour. All they did was work 1 hour. We done worked all day long. And you gave us a penny just like them. But Yahusha answered one of them and said, friend, I do thee no wrong. Didn't you agree for me to pay you a penny? Take that which is thine and go away. Go your way. I will give unto the last even as unto thee. Is it not lawful for me to do what I will with my own? Is thine eye evil because I am good? So the last shall be first, and the first shall be last. Oh, it's not like we think it is in the kingdom. It's the last. It's the one who has always been downtrodden. The one who is, when Yahusha first came into the world, he came among the poor. He came among those that had nothing, the shepherds, the farmers, the poor. And in these last days, he's coming the same way. But it's not going to be those that have ruled over everyone, but those who have been last. The last shall be first. That's you, Israel. That's you, the Negro. The last shall be first, and the first shall be last. See, Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro kingdom world where it's not like you think it is. Those that you think is going to be first, the high muckety mucks in the kingdom, in the church, they're not going to be first. He's talking about his people there. This is before Gentiles even could get saved. Remember, he said, I came not but for the house of Israel. He came for those that were last. Rejoice, family. Rejoice, Israel. True Jacob. You will be first. Remember the scripture in the Apocrypha says that Esau is the end of the world. Esau is ruling the world now. But Jacob is that which cometh after we got next. See, Yahusha's world is a bizarro kingdom. It's not quite what you think. Let's go to the next one. Matthew chapter 23. Then Yahusha spake to the multitude and to his disciples, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. All therefore, whatsoever they bid you, observe. Watch what they're doing. Observe and do. Do what they say, because they read the scriptures. But do not ye after their works. See, do what they say, because they're going to preach the word. But don't do what they do. They're bizarro. Wrong kingdom. Hallelujah. For they say, and do not. For they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne, and lay them on men's shoulders. They put plenty burdens on the people. This is why this channel comes to encourage. But they themselves will not move with them one of their fingers. But all their works they do for to be seen of men. They make broad their phylacteries and enlarge the borders of their garments. They look the part. And love the uppermost rooms at the feast. They love the best seats, the chief seats in the synagogues, and greetings in the markets, and to be called of men rabbi, rabbi. They like to be called bishop, apostle, pastor. Come on now. It ain't what you think. See, in Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro world kingdom. It's just the opposite of what you think it is. Hallelujah. And call no man your father upon the earth, for one is your father, which is in the Shamaim in heaven. Neither be ye called masters, for One is your master, even Christ. It says, listen, but he that is greatest among you shall be servant. It's not like we think it's going to be. We think we have to be great. The greatest among you, brother, the greatest among you, sisters, shall be the servant of all. See, Yahushua's kingdom is a bizarro world kingdom. It's kind of like, not like you think it is. And whosoever shall exalt himself shall be abased, shall fall. And he that humble himself shall be exalted. See, Yahushua's world, his kingdom is a bizarro kingdom. It's kind of not quite like we thought it was. Let's go to the next one. Hallelujah. The next scripture is in Luke chapter 21. And this is in verse 1 through 4. It says, and he looked up and saw the rich men casting their gifts into the treasury. They making it rain in there, right? Oh, look at me. I just threw some hundreds in there, some hundreds, fifties, some twenties. And he saw also a certain poor widow casting in thither two mites. Just say two pennies. And he said, this is Yahushua himself, of a truth I say unto you, this poor widow hath cast in more than they all. For all these have their abundance, have of their abundance cast into the offerings of Yahuwah. But she, of her penury, in her brokenness, she has cast in all the living that she had. She gave out her heart of worship. See, it ain't just who got the money. Me and my wife was talking about this today, and we were praying about this, that just because you have a lot of stuff, it does not equate to righteousness. Hallelujah. She gave more than them all, even though she gave two pennies, because she gave with a heart of worship. See, Yahushua's kingdom is a bizarro world kingdom. It's kind of like not quite what we thought it was. Hallelujah. Give me this last one. This one no long lesson. One more. Luke chapter 18. Listen at this. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and to faint not. There's a message right there, family. Don't never give up. He who endures to the end, the same shall be saved. Men ought always pray and faint not. Don't give up, saying, there was in a city a judge which feared not Yahuwah, neither regarded men. He didn't care nothing about our Elohim. He didn't care nothing about men around him. And there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him and saying, avenge me my adversary. No, that's not the one. I'm sorry. Let's go to the next one. It's at verse 9. Forgive me. I'm tying it in. Remember, Yahushua's kingdom is a bizarro kingdom. It's not quite what we thought it was. And he spake this parable unto certain which trusted in themselves that they were righteous and despised others. Two men went up into the temple to pray, the one a Pharisee and the other a publican. A publican is a sinner. He knows he's a sinner. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus within himself. He prayed like this, God, I thank thee that I am not as other men. They are extortioners. They are unjust and adulterers. Or even as this publican here, this sinner. I fast twice in a week. I give tithes of all that I possess. and the publican. Oh, hallelujah. Help me, Holy Spirit. Help me, Ruach. The publican standing afar off. Because when you know you've been doing wrong, family, and you know you've been doing wrong, you know that thing you did. I know that thing I did. You know those things you used to do. And I know those things I used to do. This is how he came in. This is why he was standing back. He came into the church and sat in the back row. That's why I used to say that. That's what a filthy sin. That's what I thought. I would never go in the front. And the publican standing far off would not even so as lift his eyes unto the Shamahim. He couldn't even bring himself to look up. He couldn't even do it. Why this other man is bragging about his righteousness and who he is, this Pharisee. We have to be careful, brethren, coming into this truth of who we are, not to turn into Pharisees. Yah wants us to have a relationship with him. See, Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro kingdom. It's reverse of, kind of not like we thought it was. And the publican standing far off would not lift up so much as his eyes unto heaven, but smote upon his breast, beating himself. Paul even said, I beat my body and make it obedient unto Hamashiach. But this man was beating it because he hated himself. He just smote upon his breast saying, Yahuwah, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this is Yahusha talking, this man went down to his house, this publican, this sinner, this wretch. He went down to his house. He went back home justified, forgiven, rather than the other. For everyone that exalted himself shall be brought low. Humility, none of us deserve his blood poured out for us. None of us deserve the beating he took, the scars, the whipping, the lashes, the hanging, the imprisonment, the ridicule, the mocking, the scorning. Everyone that exalted himself shall be abased, shall be brought low. And he that humbled himself, like that poor brother came in knowing that he had no other way except that Yahusha, who is Yahuwah himself, I and the Father are one, would forgive him. He went home forgiven. You see, Yahusha's kingdom, family, is a bizarro world kingdom. It's sort of like, not like we, quite like we thought it was. We have to live that bizarro life in this kingdom, hallelujah, different than everybody else. Humble, serving one another, loving each other, giving to the poor, having a heart for Yah and his people, having a heart for those who are struggling and going through. Family, that was pretty much all I had to bring to you today, but to remind you that we are Israel. The last shall be first. You're going to be first, true Israel. This is why this world is blowing up. This is why the wars and rumors of wars are going on, because these nations, they know, they conspired, they know. They conspired to keep us blinded and to who we are as a people. So now that we are woke, They rather blow this world up than to have these niggers in charge running the kingdom. But it's gonna happen because Yahusha's kingdom is a bizarro world kingdom. It's like, you know, sort of like, not like we thought it was. Hallelujah. We are Israel. Rejoice, family. Stay humble. Give to the poor. Love one another. Be the servant of all. That's how you great in the kingdom. And I'll see you in the wilderness on the other side. Also, you Gentile brethren, we don't forget you. We know the scriptures. They left with a mixed multitude. It wasn't just a mixed multitude of the tribes. It was Gentiles that went back in the land. The scriptures say so in, is it Joel? Or is it Isaiah? Where they're going to take some back into our land with us for servants and handmaids. Get ready, family. That's why this world is stirred up right now. Because this whole world is ready for the sons of Yahuwah to be revealed.
Hallelujah.
Swing Sevens, family. I'll holler at you later. Y'all be blessed. I love y'all. I love y'all. Hallelujah. I love y'all. Amen. I'm set. I love y'all, fam. I do. Hallelujah.